Welcome to the Silk UI overview session. In this session, the topics that we'd like to discuss are what is Silk UI and look at its definition and principles, take a quick look at the Silk UI website to see some of the information that is available there, and then discuss some of the details about the Silk UI themes and the Silk UI patterns. So let's go ahead and get started. Silk UI is a codeless UI framework, and here you can see that it's available on mobile devices, and it creates the look and feel and enables us to quickly create great user interfaces, and those user interfaces can be targeted to particular devices. So here you can see that a task manager app is on the phone with a set of lists and other types of things, and the same thing is available on the tablet, and it adapts and changes to the look and feel depending on the type of device. So Silk UI is this framework that is available for both mobile and web apps. So if we try to define it specifically, Silk UI is a codeless UI framework that enables developers to quickly create amazing user interfaces with pre-built patterns and samples. And you can simply drag and drop these patterns, set some properties, and go ahead and create them. Now, Silk UI was created because inside of the OutSystems servers, when we do development, we want things to be highly productive and we want things to look as good as possible and be easy to work with. So the principles that were designed into Silk UI were that the UI had to look great, it had to perform really well, and it had to follow the best practices of user interface design and how things work. And while doing all of those things, it had to be easy for developers to use and allow us to create overall great user interfaces and do it really quickly. So those were the principles that Silk UI were built upon. Now, to learn more about Silk UI, the quickest and easiest place to get more info is our website. And to get to the Silk UI website, you can go to silkui.outsystems.com. And it's broken up into a couple areas. There's a home area. There's an area to show off the templates, some of the samples of what Silk UI can do, the patterns, and a getting started area. So we'll talk about each one of these areas in a little more detail. So the home basically gets to give us an overview of what's there and discuss how different parts of mobile apps and web apps have been set up for Silk UI to go ahead and help us create those types of apps quickly. There's also a template area, and the template area shows us the different types of templates that are available. And there are mobile templates like the phone and the tablet template, and then there are different types of web templates. So here we can see the phone, and for the templates we follow some sort of theme. So we have a phone theme and a tablet theme. And then we have for the web different types of websites or look and feel. So here we have a Lisbon website, and we give some of the web themes different types of city names. So here we have a Dublin that has a nice left-hand nav, and a Liverpool that has red and black across the top. So a number of different themes that are available to work with. And then besides the themes, which help define the overall screen, what we put inside of the screen, like the smaller components that are available, are referred to as patterns. And those patterns are reusable and customizable elements that we can work with, and we'll look at a number of those. So when we think of Silk UI, obviously having a big look and feel is great, but having all of those patterns that are reusable patterns, how did we come up with what those patterns should be? So to determine what patterns should be the different types of reusable components, we went out and looked at 70 of the most popular apps in the world. And in evaluating those 70 most popular apps in the world, what we found is that 84% of all of the components on those apps were actually very reusable and noticeable types of components. So inside of OutSystems, We created a number of those as built-in widgets and what we also call composite patterns. So the composite patterns are a little bit larger components, and the 20 built-in widgets are more fundamental building blocks. But with these 20 plus and 50 plus widgets and patterns, more than 80% of the websites and the apps would have been built with these types of components. So if Silk UI can provide these and we can build them by dragging and dropping and configuring them very quickly, then we'd be able to build a huge amount of the functionality that is expected very quickly and very easily. So if we think about mobile apps and we break down some of the things that we might see inside of a mobile screen, there are different areas like headers. Sometimes there's a card that shows off different information in an area, and it might have some sort of background image. Sometimes we have multiple images that can be swiped, and that is referred to as a carousel. We might have some icons available with some buttons and things near the bottom bar. And we may have counters that are showing us the different types of information that's available. So mobile apps can be broken into these smaller components, and these smaller components are what we refer to as those patterns. So there are a lot of different mobile patterns. We're not going to go through all of these now. We'll have a chance to look at these more. But if you go to the website, each one of these is, there is an example of how each one of these works, a description, and a picture of how it actually works. So going to the website will give you the details that you might be interested in when you're looking at using some of these types of patterns. There are also patterns for the web apps, and when you break up a website and you look at what's available, it may be a little bit different as far as having sort of a bar at the top with different tiles and panels that can have charts and other types of things inside of them, but in general we still would be able to break sites up into different types of standard patterns and components. So there are a set of web patterns, and again each one of these is a link that is documented with examples and other types of information of those patterns. So with all of those patterns, you know, we've now seen the templates and the patterns, we may want to see some of these things actually working. So there is a large number of sample apps and sample pages, and when you're looking for more information, you can go out and select one of the samples and it will show you those types of patterns or themes and information that is available on those particular types of samples. So there are over 50 samples just in the mobile side with the phone and the tablet, and there are also quite a few for the web apps. And then finally, we have the Getting Started area. And inside of the Getting Started area, there is a place to be able to download the different themes and templates that you may need or wish to use. And there's also a frequently asked questions section where you can look at more information about how the different patterns might work, how you can use them in development, or how you can support and maintain the latest versions of Silk UI. So in this session, we tried to define what Silk UI is as far as a framework to allow us to create great interfaces. We showed you the website where you can go and get the most information and see all of the different components. We described the themes and the patterns in a little bit of detail so that you know where to go and find those different types of patterns. So hopefully this gets you started and makes you feel a little bit more comfortable. Please go to the website and view more of the information about Silk UI.